I'm Shelli Sonstein, and this is a herFLiX moment.
Sarah Jessica Parker stars in I Don't Know How She Does It. She stars as a career woman, high-powered career, and she has a family. She has kids. She has a loving husband. How does she do it? Does she have it all? Can you have it all? Let's take a look at the trailer.
A recent study showed that women with young children don't sleep through the night. Researchers were at a loss to explain why. They could have asked me.
Taxi!
Instead of sleeping, I do the list. Number one.
Take Emily to school.
I am just so jealous you get to look nice all day. We just frump around at the park.
Number two. Keep my head above water at work.
Sarah, are you running a little late this morning?
I have two choices here. The man's excuse, bad traffic, down power lines, faulty carburetor, or mammogram.
Oh.
Number three, spend more time with Richard.
He must be completely exhausted.
Not completely. Number four, the kids. Kindergarten bake sale, Christmas lights, birthday party.
I don't know how you do it.
I don't know how you do it.
I don't know how she does it. All those children.
I have two.
So impressive.
You have four.
Yeah, but two of mine are twins.
Jack Abelhammer in our New York office has sparked to a proposal, and he'd like to meet the author.
Have you been there?
Long enough, but go ahead. If there's anything else you need to adjust.
This could be a big step up. Gives your kids a chance to spend all that extra quality time they've been hoping for with your nanny.
Did you take Ben to get his haircut?
Yeah.
Oh, that was his first haircut.
His first haircut. Missing everything.
I love my work, although sometimes I wish I didn't love it so much.
You're allowed to miss your children.
I need somebody down there tonight.
We can't go on like this.
Can't quit, Kate. Don't you think about not having to worry about priorities all the time? Don't know what we're capable of. Me without that job isn't me, but also me without you and Ben and Emily is nothing.
Just about to make the biggest mess out of our entire lives, and you're gonna use sex to pretend everything's okay? Is that the plan?
Yes.
I like it.
I have to tell you, heading into this interview with Sarah Jessica Parker, I mean, she really is Carrie Bradshaw, right? So I was seriously stressing about what to wear, so I hope it looks okay. I think I got her blessing. I got to speak to her and Greg Kinnear at the same time, so let's take a look.
40 years after the start of the women's rights movement, we're still asking the same question, can you have it all?
Wendy Wasserstein, the great, she said, I remember in one of her plays, she always said, I want love and literature, and I think it was the same thing, and I think you can make attempts to have it all, but I think inevitably you will find yourself coming up short. And I think the answer to that is you just simply have to reconcile that and have that be okay. I think we all want rich, interesting, full, complicated lives. And if that is our choice, there will be consequences.
Greg, your mom, Jane Curtin, in the movie.
For a second, I was thinking, my mom, Jane Curtin? Is it true? I don't remember that.
She makes an interesting comment to Jane.
You choose to make
it. We had it so much easier because, you know,
everyone knew their roles.
The woman stayed home.
Sure.
The man went to work. Actually, in your family, in the film, the roles are kind of reversed.
No, I think that's true, and it's. I think that story has happened. Is happened and is happening now more than probably any other time. So I think that it's relevant. This is a particularly, you know, I think fertile ground because you have two people who both, in this, you know, story, you have a couple people both trying to keep jobs together and have kids and keep a marriage alive and deal with immediate family members and all of the, everything that goes in the middle of it. And I think that, you know, something has to break along the way. And it's the process of trying to juggle that and keep it together that is kind of what the story follows on this, hopefully in an amusing way.
I so wanted to love this movie, but I didn't love this movie. I love things about this movie. I love the theme. It absolutely resonates. I think Sarah Jessica Parker is immensely, immensely likable. Greg Kinnear was outstanding as her husband. It was wonderful to have this loving husband. He was not the major breadwinner. She was the breadwinner. That was good. He was wonderful with the kids. He wasn't one of these awkward fathers who doesn't know, who is clueless when it comes to the kids. That much I loved. I also loved Olivia Munn as the cold, officious co-worker of Sarah Jessica Parker. I have to tell you, she stole every single scene she was in. And they should give that woman a spin-off. That character I want to see more of. What I didn't like, when they went into this slapsticky whole thing with her with the head lice, enough already. It went on and on and on. And it was just too neatly tied up with a bow at the end. I just hate when a romantic comedy ends exactly the way I know it's going to end 5 minutes into the movie. Unfortunately, and I hate the title. It's hard to remember. I don't know how she does it. Uh-uh. Not gonna roll off the tongue. Sadly, I give this one 2 coffee cups.
This has been a herFLiX moment.